In the modern world, we have access to a wide variety of different events. However, this also means that the process of planning and organizing an event can become quite complex.
This has led to the emergence of event management as a profession. An event planner is a professional within this industry who is hired to organize all the tasks associated with an event. So, before planning an event planner must know what type of event they are organizing.
Julia Rutherford Silver has divided events into 10 different categories. What do you think these categories could be?
Well, the different categories of events are as follows. Corporate events, course-related and fundraising events, exhibitions, expositions and fairs, entertainment and leisure events, festivals, government and civic events, marketing events, meetings and conventions, social events, and lastly, sports events. Let's look at some examples. Imagine that you are attending the local agricultural show in your town. There are food stalls, farming equipment on display, and livestock sales. This event would fall into the category of a fair, as it brings like-minded people together to buy and sell products. The agricultural show also includes the Eastern Cape Show Jumping Horse Trials. All show jumpers from around the Eastern Cape come to compete at this event. This type of event would be considered a competitive sporting event. While at the show, you walk past a stall selling the most delicious looking sweet treats. You decide to buy some cupcakes from the ladies running the stall. They tell you that the profits from the sales of these treats will go toward the local dog shelter. In this instance, the stall at the agricultural show would be considered a fundraising event because the money being raised is going to a good cause.
Now let's imagine that your friend is coming to visit for the weekend.
She's coming down on Friday for her company's annual board meeting. A meeting is an event where people gather to exchange information, discuss ideas, or make decisions. Friday also happens to be her 30th birthday, so you organize a surprise party at a local restaurant. You invite roughly 40 people for a Mexican-themed evening. This would be considered a social event that celebrates a special occasion. You also know that one of your friend's favorite singers is performing at a concert on Sunday, so you book 2 tickets as her birthday present. This event would fall under entertainment, because it is a one-time event that functions to entertain people.
As you can see, events do not always fall into one specific category. One event can have multiple different categories, and we can attend various types of events over a period. This can make the job of the event planner rather complicated. For this reason, an event planner must clearly understand what type of event they are planning before they begin.